Evidence of Vancouver Island's rich history is all around us, but you might not know that it is also beneath our feet, and that is particularly true in Nanaimo. The first European settlers were drawn to the region by black gold, and they built the harbour city and the coal mining industry. CTV's Bruce Williams takes us back in time tonight to show us what it was like to toil in those mines underground.
Come and listen, you fellers, so young and so fine, and seek not your fortune in the dark, dreary mines. It will form as a habit and seep in your soul, till the stream of your blood runs as black as the coal. Where it's dark as a dungeon and damp as the dew, where the danger is double and the pleasures are few, where the rain never falls.
It really wasn't much of a life, was it?
No, dirty, dusty, dangerous, all those things.
This represents an example of what a mine would have looked like underneath Vancouver Island, right?
Yeah. Well, this is a little nicer. This is warmer, drier, bigger, lighter, brighter.
There is part of the display at the museum that shows you exactly how low the ceiling was in these mines. The whole experience, though, is very realistic.
Actually, a lot of people are a little nervous about walking through, because when you come in, you can't see where you're coming out. So and that was part of what we wanted to portray. And people like the stories, they like the strike, they like learning more about the personal stories and the specific things that happen to local people. So this is a map of Nanaimo with kind of where the workings were, maybe underneath your house. This is the Douglas seam, or the upper seam, but it went down to about 1,700 feet underground. So the Newcastle seam, a little smaller, around Newcastle Island, and the Wellington seam, which is another deeper one and a larger seam that went across a long part of Nanaimo.
This is pretty scary looking stuff in here. What is this?
Well, this is kind of the basics of what you did. You broke that coal out of the ground and shoveled it into a cart and hauled it up to the surface.
And this thing down here with the wheels and the teeth and that's a...
A winch. Later, a little later development, the winch would actually pull those carts up instead of donkeys.
Really? So donkeys were used in the mines?
They were, yeah.
I don't think that'd be very good for them either.
Well, not much of a life for them either, no.
Part of the display at the museum also shows how unsafe it was in the mines. In fact, one part of it talks about one of BC's biggest disasters ever.
Number one mine explosion in 1887 claimed 153 miners, and it's the largest disaster in British Columbia and one of the largest in Canada.
Wow. This watch here is just, it's very eerie.
It is. It's one of my favorite things, actually. It was Robert MacArthur's watch, and he was part of the Protection Island cage accident in 1918, and his watch stopped, of course, at the time that the cage crashed.
By the way, there is also a mineshaft exhibit at the Cumberland Museum in the town of Cumberland in the Comox Valley. Check that one out, and this one here at the Nanaimo Museum as well. To find out more about what happens here, go to the website, which is nanaimomuseum.ca. And you know what? You learn a lesson here that every time you think you're having a bad day, think about the people that had that kind of a day every time they went to work. Oh, and by the way, safety first. Be careful. Bruce Williams, CTV News, Nanaimo.